We just got done watching Ready or Not, Caleb. Yes.
Not Hide and Seek, which is what I told the ticket guy whenever I came up, because I forgot the name of the movie.
You know, well, you know, it's scary stories to tell in the dark.
Yeah,
or scary movies to tell in the dark.
Like somebody
else. It's been one of those evenings with people in the movie theater.
I guess it's just such a weird name it's just a weird name for a movie that a bunch of different titles came in my head whenever I came up to the. Yeah. I didn't know a lot about this movie. I saw a trailer for it a while back, then the reviews started circulating. Whenever a certain amount of reviews come in, like 6 or 7, and you're like, well, this doesn't mean anything. Like,
right.
It premiered at a mostly horror based festival.
So I'm like, especially, you know, if Bloody Disgusting says something, then you.
Yeah, I call it the Blair Witch
Effect.
Where Blair Witch had like 100 on Rotten Tomatoes.
Bloody Disgusting! This movie's 5 stars, 100%, the scariest movie you will see all year, all decade, all your life. And then it just says shit.
Yeah, it was at 100 for a long time, then it dropped 35 or something.
Drastically.
This hasn't dropped that much.
No.
So I was curious to see how it played out. I didn't know how strong the horror elements would be or how strong the comedy elements would be. And I've seen this actress in a couple things. She had a small role in 3 Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. And the rest of the cast,
Run!
The rest of the cast, you got...
Hide!
Veteran like Annie McDowell, who plays the mother. Mm-hmm. And... Adam Brody, haven't seen him in anything in a long time. So, mostly a cast that I don't know that well.
Right.
So, it's a movie I don't know that well going in, and I don't think you knew anything about it.
Nope. I saw the trailer once.
And a cast that you probably know less than I do. What do you think about
it? Thought it was Margot Robbie.
She looks a little bit like Margot Robbie.
When I first saw the trailer for this movie, I thought that was Margot Robbie.
And she's Australian as well, so maybe there's a connection there.
It was fun. It was fun. I wouldn't say it was great. Mm-hmm. But it was fun. I had fun watching it. Like, it's a good matinee popcorn flick, like horror film. It's not like if you're going into it expecting Evil Dead, don't go into it expecting Evil Dead.
Yeah.
Because it's like, as far as like horror comedies go.
To me, I agree with that completely. To me, this movie has cult hit written all over it.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Even as the movie was going on, certain characters are like, man, these characters are going to be very memorable 10 years from now.
Yeah.
So I think...
Especially the father.
I think the father
is going to be hilarious.
You got the father.
The grandmother.
You got the...
Not the grandmother. It's the aunt. She's an aunt.
You got the guy... Was it the butler?
Yes, the butler.
The butler that keeps singing along to classical music. And you got the daughter that's the drug addict. And then you got Adam Brody. And, of course, you got our lead character. There's just so many characters here that I just enjoyed watching. You got the guy that I know you didn't, you wanted to see die instantly, but that guy squeezed quite a few laughs out of me. I wanted him to get hit by a bus.
And it never happened. It's not a spoiler because you don't know who I'm talking about.
The blending of the comedy and horror in this movie, I think, is pretty seamless.
It worked.
I think it's, if we're discluding movies like Get Out and Us, I don't consider them horror comedies. They're more so like a thriller and a horror movie.
No. I wouldn't even consider Get Out. Well,
it's more of a thriller. It's a social political thriller, right. And Us is a horror movie.
Yeah.
This is
one of the best. Like, I don't want to be like to beat a dead horse here, but the horror franchise to me, or not franchise, but the whole genre after Cabin in the Woods, and we've said this before on some of our past movies that after Cabin in the Woods came out, we hold horror movies to that standard of what a horror film should be. It should turn the genre on its head because we've seen this. We've seen slasher films. We've seen, you know, the thrillers and like the type of horror films where it's like a nightmare and stuff like that. We've seen that. This kind of brings it down to earth. It's not too outlandish.
It's got more
it's
of
not,
a...
The plot's outlandish, but the things that happen in the film isn't outlandish.
It definitely has more of a Cabin in the Woods Scream type feel to it, which is what I was leading to. Is that, like I said, if we're discluding movies like Get Out and Us, I think this is one of the best combinations of horror and comedy I've seen since Cabin in the Woods. If I'm just thinking off the top of my head, because there's been a lot of really great horror movies since Cabin in the Woods, but those are the horror movies that are really deep and sad and depressing. This isn't any of that. This is a really fun movie. And also, some of the best usage of making comedy out of violence that I've seen. I think some of the biggest laughs in this movie come from some brutal kills. Like the first brutal kill will get a huge laugh out of you. There was only 3 people in our theater, Us.
Yes, it was us. Yeah, there was literally three people in the theater.
And I think it would have been even better if there was a bigger crowd, which worries me. I know you can't judge everything by our local theater, but it worries me that the movie isn't going to do that well, which is why I'm leaning towards the fact that it might be a cult hit someday. Mm-hmm. I think it'll catch on sometime down the road.
I think the problem is, too, is that I didn't really see a lot of marketing for this film. Other than, like, the one trailer. I haven't seen any TV spots. I haven't seen anything, like... The movie... To me, it seems like the movie doesn't have a big marketing budget behind it to where... It's gonna make a lot of money. And the fact that it released 4 days early too, which is weird. I didn't even realize that.
It came out on Tuesday
yeah. instead of a Thursday.
Yeah. That was weird.
And if it was just three of us in there on today, on a Thursday, when movies usually are preview screened for our theater, that just worries me that nobody was there for Tuesday and Wednesday.
You know, I've been watching more actual like TV lately. I usually don't, but I have been watching more TV, and I've seen a couple TV spots for it, but not enough to push it over where
it
would draw people in that aren't usually like watching movies like that. It is, for better or for worse, it is sort of a niche film, I think, because some people aren't going to be down with the comedy, with the violence, and some people are going to want a straight-up horror movie, and it's not that.
It's not.
But I thought it was... In a time where we get a lot of bigger movies that are either sequels or comic book movies or adaptations of things that we know, it's really cool and refreshing to see an original movie like this. And we saw Good Boys last week, and I would love to see this in get one or two in the box office. That'd be super cool to have 2 weeks in a row of like two original and cool movies.
Right. It's probably not. It's probably get 4 or 5.
Could probably get 4 or 5.
I would say Good Boys is probably going to repeat this weekend.
It might, unless the Fallen movie does well. Which I don't know. Or the religious movie, you never know.
Yeah.
But I think I actually like this movie more than you. Because I really...
No, that's fine. I mean, I have no problem with the film.
This was one of my... I'm not going to say it was one of my favorite movies of the year, but this is one of the better times I had watching a movie in a movie theater. And I guess you could, if you've watched the trailer, it does give away some aspect. But there's one thing I didn't know, and I'm not even sure if I want to say it in the... It does play a big part in the trailer, but there is somewhat of a supernatural element to the movie that lingers throughout the movie.
Yeah.
And I didn't know that was a thing. And I thought that was really interesting. I thought it played on different fears.
It's very Cabin in the Woods-esque.
You remind me of Drag Me to Hell a little bit.
That too. Yeah. Of the whole, you know, we have to do this or the demons are going to get us.
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
And there is a payoff for which is good.
Do you think the movie earns that ending? Like what happens? Because I personally I didn't know what was going to happen. Either way, leaning towards either way, I would have been okay with it.
Yeah.
But it was so bombastic and over the top that I loved it.
Yeah.
Like I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That it deserved what it.
It was good.
Got.
Listen, the movie is what it is. It's tongue in cheek horror comedy, black comedy. It's not the deepest thing ever.
It gets
some really good performances out of actors that you either haven't seen in a while or you just don't know. And there's some really cool and clever dialogue. And the violence is really good. And it's also sort of smart at times.
It has its moments.
In a year where I find horror to be lacking, with the exception of like a couple movies like Midsommar and Us, this is like third best horror movie I've seen this year.
Second best because I didn't get to see Midsommar.
Because before this, third... Best horror movie this year was probably like Happy Death Day to You, and I think this is better than that.
Yeah. They're similar, but
that's more of a comedy.
That's more of a comedy than this.
Yeah, science fiction comedy.
So score.
I give this the same thing that I gave Good Boys last week, an A-.
Really?
This is a top 10. This hasn't been a great year for film. This is a top 10 movie of the year for me so far.
Okay.
So what do you give it?
I give it a B+. It almost gets to an A-. Yeah. But if I watched it again, I probably would, with a theater that would enjoy it.
With more people.
With more people, probably.
Yeah, I think you'd get more laughs and you'd feed off that energy.
But as a standalone, you know, film, B+.
That's why
it's good.
This movie will get better over time. That's why I'm saying it has that that cultish...
Yeah.
This is honestly just a way, way, way better version of Your Next that came out.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Like,
this is way better.
Like, Your Next was cool, but this is so much better and smarter and
funnier.
And that's
what I was thinking. It was at the very end scene when... Not going to spoil the film, but the very end of the movie.
Yeah.
I'm sitting there going... man, this felt like you're next.
Yeah,
and I wanted to look at you and be like, did you get your next vibe out of this? Yeah. And that, in my mind, it's, that's what it was going through
your
my mind.
Your next was supposed to be this huge subversive horror movie that flips the genre on its side. It really didn't. It wasn't even directed that well. I think the direction in this is pretty excellent. It has some really cool shots. Cinematography's cool, and the acting's really good.
Like, yeah, to touch on it quickly, set pieces in this film is fantastic.
Yeah, yeah.
They're so cool. Yeah. Like it literally feels like an 18th century, 19th century
house. Yeah, it's cool. The set design's great.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
this movie's a blast. Go watch this movie. This movie needs your money. I assume probably didn't have a huge budget, but consider this. This is now a Disney movie, technically, because it's a Fox Searchlight movie. So, this main actress, she's technically a Disney queen. So, give your money to this movie. It needs it. Please, like, for the love of God, support this movie.
Yeah.
That's our opinion. We both...
Let's get it a sequel!
Hey, if they come up with a good script, sure. I don't see how it's possible, but let's give it a shot. That's how we felt about the movie. Let us know what you thought of this movie in the comment section below. Hit that subscribe button, and thank you for watching.